Hello, welcome. My name is Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's Total Wellness Dietitian. Today we're back for another episode of ProMedica's Healthy Cooking Demonstrations. Today we feature a recipe that can use some turkey leftovers that you might have from Thanksgiving. This is going to be a Greek lemon turkey pasta. And now we'll go through the ingredients. So to start off the Greek lemon turkey pasta, we're going to have 1 tablespoon and 3/4 teaspoon of low sodium soy sauce, 1 tablespoon and 3/4 teaspoon of 100% lemon juice, 1.5 teaspoons of minced garlic, which is roughly equal to 3 cloves of garlic. We're going to need 1 3/4 teaspoon of ground black pepper. Then we need roughly about 1/2 tablespoon of grated lemon peel. We have roughly 1 1/4 pounds of turkey. It could be turkey breast, turkey tenderloin, or any leftover turkey that you have. We have 1 pound of whole wheat pasta, 3 tablespoons of cornstarch, which we also need cold water to make a slurry. Then we have 3 1/4 cup of low sodium chicken stock, or you can use vegetable stock. We also have 14 ounces of frozen spinach, drained and thawed. Then we have 3/4 cup of chopped yellow onion. And then we also will need another 3 tablespoons and 1/2 teaspoon of lemon juice. And you will also need some cooking spray to coat the pans as you begin to cook the product. We'll collect our water for our pasta to bring to a boil. Based on whatever the box of the whole wheat pasta you use, follow the directions.
Then we'll bring the water over to the stove, turn it on, and start the boiling process.
Now that we got our water started to boil, we're going to start with the first step. We'll add the light soy sauce, which has roughly about 40% less sodium than your regular soy sauce. Then we also will add the lemon juice, which is very acidic. And if you need it ever to curdle milk, it's a perfect ingredient to curdle your own milk. And it's a very potent flavor, which keeps the calories and the added salt down in recipes. Then we'll have your minced garlic, which is a very pungent flavor and aroma. We'll add that in there. And just a little tip, if you use regular fresh garlic, to store your garlic cloves, always keep the top on, because if you take the top off, the garlic will become rancid quicker. And as the garlic is cut and minced, small enzyme reactions interact, and that's why it's such a potent smell and a potent flavor. It's a little defensive mechanism made by the plant. We'll add our ground black pepper. And then we need to collect the zest from the lemon. And the zest is going to be all the yellow from the lemon, not the white, that's the pith. That's a very bitter part of the fruit. For 1 medium lemon, typically you'll get about 1 tablespoon of lemon zest and also 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. So now that we have our lemon zest, we'll add that to the other ingredients that we have. Now that we have all our ingredients in the mixing bowl, we'll just quickly give it a stir to start them having their flavors infused. And we'll put that off to the side while we cut our turkey cutlets. And here again we have, these are turkey tenderloins, and if you are cooking this after Thanksgiving, you might already have some pre-cooked turkey. That's okay to use. The cooking time will have to decrease though, because you don't want that turkey to become dry. Now, a lot of times with Thanksgiving, people are concerned with eating the dark meat of the turkey, thinking that it's higher in fat and higher in calories. But actually, 1 ounce of light turkey meat versus 1 ounce of dark turkey meat only has roughly 4 calories difference, 46 calories in the white to 50 calories in the dark. The reason that the dark meat is dark is myoglobin, which helps bring oxygen to those muscles. And that myoglobin stays in those muscles, making it a darker color. It's not added fat, it's just myoglobin. Another one of the misconceptions with Thanksgiving and turkey is that the tryptophan found in the turkey is what makes you tired after the big meal. The fact is, when you have all those carbohydrates and fat, that's what's making you tired after the big Thanksgiving meal, not the tryptophan. Your body has to work so hard to break it down that you get a little bit sleepy. You can cut the meat at any thickness you want, but I'm cutting it nice and thin. That'll cut down on cooking time while also keeping the meat as moist as it can be, because turkey can dry out pretty quickly. Now that we have the turkey all cut up, we're gonna mix that into our marinade. And then just stir it up to coat it evenly. Now you might not think there's enough marinade, but all those potent flavors, the garlic, the soy sauce, that'll coat this turkey well and spread the flavors throughout the meat. Now that the turkey is mixed into the marinade, we're gonna let it sit in the refrigerator for a little bit while we start on the next steps. We're gonna start our pasta, our water's boiling. Be careful and slowly put the pasta in. Give it a little shake to stir it around to make sure it doesn't stick. Now that we have the whole grain pasta cooking, we're going to briefly talk about what the benefits of having whole grains in your diet are. A lot of people don't understand what the whole grains are. A whole grain keeps all the components of the grain intact: the bran, the endosperm, and the germ. When you have an enriched product, they take all the good stuff out, the bran and the germ, and leave the endosperm, the starchy center. Also, having whole grains, you have all the phytonutrients and phytochemicals that are found in the grain. Those are the components that have been shown to help prevent cancer and various other health ailments. According to the Whole Grain Council, 3 servings daily of whole grains have been shown in various studies to decrease your chance of diabetes by roughly 20 to 30%. Stroke by 30 to 35%, and heart disease roughly by 25%. Now you might say, what is a serving? A serving includes roughly a half cup of rice, half cup of pasta, half cup of oatmeal, or even just one slice of whole grain bread. The next step, we're gonna make our slurry to make the sauce thicker. We don't want a watery sauce, and so we're gonna use cornstarch and a little bit of cold water, about 3 tablespoons to 3 tablespoons. We'll make a little slurry, and you have to use cold water, because if you use warm water, the cornstarch will start clumping and it'll never unclump. So you have to use cold water. And it should be evenly distributed throughout the water, and you'll see you have a nice liquid without any clumps. Now that we have the pan coated in nonstick cook spray, we're going to add the turkey. And try to get as much of the liquid out of the bowl as you can, and then quickly stir that up, because that turkey will stick. Okay. Now that we have the turkey starting to cook, we'll turn the heat up a little bit, medium high, and you're gonna have to watch that so it doesn't overcook. Now we're gonna cover the turkey and let it cook there before we add the chicken stock and the spinach. Now that our turkey's cooking, we're gonna cut up our onion before we add the chicken stock, spinach, other lemon juice, and the onion. A lot of times as you start cutting onions, your eyes will start to water or you'll start crying. The reason behind that is the onion is releasing gas, which irritates your eye. The gas is being released due to 2 chemical reactions that are taking place as you cut the onion. To reduce this chemical reaction, either cut your onions under cold running water or in a cold water basin, cutting the root last, or also chilling the onion prior to cutting. Now that we have our onion chopped up, we're going to add our low sodium chicken stock and our spinach. But I want to briefly talk about the health benefits of spinach. Spinach is a nutritional all-star, rich in vitamins A, C, E, calcium, and iron. The problem with the calcium and iron is various components inside the spinach prohibit it from being absorbed well by the human body. Your human body only roughly absorbs 5% of the calcium that's found in the spinach. To get the most bang for your buck nutrition-wise from your spinach, having it steamed, quickly boiled, or fresh are the best ways to go. Having frozen spinach still is very nutritional, but not as nutritional as having fresh spinach. Now that our turkey's pretty well cooked, we're gonna add our low sodium chicken stock. And as you add that, you can turn up the heat because we need this to bring to a boil. And also we wanna add our chopped spinach. You want to mix this around just to get everything spread throughout the pan. And it'll take a couple minutes to bring this up to a boil. Now that our pan's up to boiling, we're going to slowly add our slurry, which will help thicken it up. Make sure you get all the cornstarch out of the bottom if there's some extra. And then we'll stir and cook that for roughly about 5 minutes. And the sauce should thicken up with that cornstarch. Now that the sauce has cooked for roughly about 5 minutes and thickened up, we're going to add our lemon juice and also our onions. Just let those sweat for a couple minutes, and we'll add our pasta after we drain it, and then I'll plate it up for you and we'll do a little taste test. Excellent dish. The lemon really stands out, provides a nice citrus taste. The garlic with a nice undertone, the spinach adds a nice earthy flavor, and that turkey is cooked perfectly. Again, I'd like to thank you for watching this ProMedica Healthy Cooking episode. Make sure you watch previous episodes at ProMedica.org. My name is Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's Total Wellness Dietitian, where it's our mission to improve your health and well-being.